this is an actual recording from an old 78 RPM record cut in a church. It's hand labeled. I don't think anybody's ever heard it. Here we go.
In South Dakota, Mrs. Cecil Owens translates sermons into the sign language for deaf people. Mrs. Owens has been doing this for 15 years at St. James Anglican Church. For her, it's nothing new, but for newcomers to the congregation, it's something new and unusual. I'm sure there will be other women in Canada providing this service, but I'd like to tell you about Mrs. Owens, because her job was new to me. Perhaps I shouldn't think of it as a job. We think of that as something paid for. Mrs. Owens gives her services to the church. Mrs. Owens has never taught in a school for the deaf, but few professional teachers could equal her in her eloquent and expert handling of the sign language. I say eloquent because I never realized that a sign language could be so expressive and so really beautiful. I've heard many members of the congregation remark on this. The grace with which Mrs. Owens speaks with her hands and the expression in her face. Laura Owens is not deaf herself, and she learned the language when she was a child. Both her mother and father were deaf. Her mother lost her hearing at the age of 5 following an illness. Her father's loss of hearing was also due to an early childhood illness. There were 4 children in their family, all with normal hearing. But the children, of course, learned the sign language to communicate with their mother and father. Mrs. Owens said her baby brother spoke the sign language before he talked. The family were born and raised on a farm near Ottawa. Mrs. Owens' father is dead, but her mother still is living in Ottawa. Mrs. Owens, there's no great tragedy about deafness. She describes her mother, who's now 79, as the most wonderful and the happiest woman I've ever known. Mrs. Owens said her mother's deafness seemed to present no special problems in raising her children. She said while her mother couldn't hear, she seemed to feel vibrations and could even tell when someone knocked at the door. Perhaps Laura Owens' unusually expressive handling of the sign language is because she feels it's a beautiful language. She believes it a mistake for deaf people to depend solely on lip reading and believes that all people who are hard of hearing should be able to communicate through the sign language. On Sundays, Mrs. Owens stands in the church in the midst of the congregation facing her deaf group. There are usually around 20 of them in the congregation, students from the School for the Deaf in Saskatoon, and some business people. Mrs. Owens translates both the lessons and the sermon into sign language. And the amazing thing to me is that she never lags behind Canon Roy Mannering as he preaches his sermon. It's a simultaneous translation, word for word. Many words, of course, just take one motion. For instance, Lord is the hand up on one shoulder and down across the heart. Satan is the hand of the head with the finger curled like a horn. However, there are no shortcuts to biblical means. They never have to be spelled out. Mrs. Owens confesses this is quite a task at times. For instance, a name like Nebuchadnezzar. I wouldn't be able to spell that out in a flash. So by this time, Mrs. Owens has become something of an authority on biblical spelling. Years ago, the minister used to phone her and let her know ahead of time what the lesson would be. But now she translates both the lesson and the sermon without any knowledge of them ahead of time. And she does it with an ease and a grace that's lovely to watch. And many people in the congregation, other than the hard of hearing, do watch Mrs. Owens. She said when she first started doing it, she found it a strain because so many watched her. But now she's aware only of the sermon. And so at St. James Anglican Church in Saskatoon, sermons are seen as well as heard, thanks to the special service given by Mrs. Cecil Owens for the hard of hearing.